Okay, so the next lesson is about template literals. Another really fun, useful thing about newer ECMAScript. I'm going to be saying that a lot throughout the series because so many of these things are just so useful. Anyways, template literals are enclosed by backticks. Okay, so not your apostrophe, not your quotation mark, your backtick over here. So backtick, this button right here, backtick. Okay. And then to add to your template literals, your strings, you use placeholders, and they look like dollar signs with curly brackets. Okay, so what did all that mean? Let me show you. Okay, so traditionally speaking, let's say we had a variable called user, and it's set to Fred. If we wanted to use that in a longer sentence, we would say something like a string, hello, and then close that string. And then to concatenate that, we're going to add the user to that. And then we're going to say to ServiceNow. So this is the traditional way to do it. Let's log that, see if it works. Yep, hello, Fred, to ServiceNow. Yeah, the grammar's off, but whatever, it's just a lesson. The way to do this in template literals, so let's change this around. And we're going to say let new welcome equal a backtick, remember that. Hello, let's just write it out as normal. Hello user to ServiceNow, backtick. And then we're gonna surround our variable with that dollar sign and curly brace. And then let's log that to see if we did it right. There you go, the same exact thing. But look how much easier it is to read. If I have to edit this sentence or move user around, it's so much more easier. I don't have to deal with missing the plus sign when we add the variable in. I don't have to remove a bunch of quotation marks. It's just so much easier to use template literals for string creation, especially when it has variables in it.